is Ryan, and thank you for watching this No IP support video. Today's video is designed to show our users how to add advanced text records to your domains and hostnames. These records can be added to any plus managed DNS or enhanced DNS accounts. When you log into your account, you will be able to manage your hostnames under the host-redirects tab. From here, you will be able to click Modify next to your domain or hostname that you would like to add the text record to. For this example, we will add the record to the root domain. Once you are in the Modify screen, you will see links under Advanced Records where you will be able to add different types of records. Clicking on the Text link will allow you to add a generic text record to your domain like account verifications. In this example, we will add Google's verification record. If you need to add multiple records, you will want to make sure that you are separating the records with quotation marks to make sure the records are added properly. As you can see, we have added our verification record and our other records separated out. This screen will also allow you to choose different host names if you would like these text records to be added to another host name. Once you have added the records, you will finalize it with the update button. You will get a green success message letting you know that the record has been added. To add an SPF record, you will want to click on the SPF link, which will take you to a screen which will provide you assistance in generating the record based on certain parameters. Answering the questions will auto-generate an SPF record for your domain. You can also manually add an SPF record towards the bottom of the screen by submitting the record within quotation marks like we did when adding text records. You will then finalize the addition of your record by clicking on Add SPF Record and then Update, where you will get a green success message. You can also add SPF records within the text link. The next record type will be a DKIM record, which can be added under the DKIM link. From here, you will just need to add the selector for your record and the value you want tied to it. If you need to, you can also edit the domain key policy and the ADSP for your record. For this record, we will use default as the selector and value as the fake value on the page. Clicking Create will finalize the record, and you will get a green success message when this is done. As for the SRV record, that will be added under the SRV link. Clicking on that link will bring you to the Create Record screen, where you can add the service name, protocol, priority, weight, target, port, and TTL. For this example, we will use My Services, TLS protocol, leave priority and weight as the default, have the target as the domain we are using, port as 8080, and leave the default TTL of 300 seconds. Submit will create that record for you, and you are able to see the full record further down on the page. The final record is an IPv6 record that can be created by clicking on the IPv6 link in your account. When under the creation screen, you will be able to choose the domain name and the host name you would like this record to be tied to. If you would like the record to be tied to the root domain, you can denote that with a dash. We will do that in this example. Then, you will simply add your IPv6 address and click the Submit button to create that record. Again, it will be confirmed by the green success message and will appear lower on the screen. To see text, SPF, and DKIM records, you will be able to see those under the text link of your domain. The IPv6 address can be seen in your list of host names, and the SRV record is only able to be seen under the SRV link. You can also check to see if your records are properly propagated by using whatsmydns.net. This site will check propagation of almost every record tied to your domain or hostname. You will simply need to type in the domain or the hostname and choose the record you would like to check for. You can see the Quad A or IPv6 record we have tied to the domain by changing the filter. As for the text and SPF records, those can be seen under the text filter. For the SRV record, you will need to use the hostname you created for the record and choose the SRV filter to make sure that it is resolving. You can also use MX Toolbox to check the propagation status of these records. One record type that you will not be able to add is any record with special characters like an underscore. This can be an issue with some text records and DMARC records. On screen, I have a Let's Encrypt SSL verification record and a DMARC record as examples of records that include the underscore. Even though this is not something you are able to create on the front end, we are able to create these records for you. To have these records added to your domain, you will just need to create a support ticket. You can open a ticket through our knowledge base at www.noip.com/support, or open the page directly by going to www.noip.com/ticket. Once at the ticket screen, you will just need to fill in the information requested, including domain or hostname, subject, account type, and the request, which will be to add these records to your domain. In order for our support team to make this change for you and get this done as quickly as possible, you will need to verify the account in the ticket. You can verify the account with the last form of payment, which will either be the last four digits of a credit card or the email address tied to a PayPal account. You can also verify the account with the answer to the security question that you would have had to create for your account. To verify the CNAME records have been added, you can see them in your account under the host-redirects tab, and you will be able to edit the record if need be. The DMARC record can be seen under the text link. However, unfortunately, you are not able to edit this record, but you can remove it. Once we have added these records, you will be able to check they are resolving with the same tool. You will need to use the full hostname or record selector to make sure that you are able to see these resolving correctly. Thank you for watching this NoIP support video. Please like and subscribe to see all future content, and if you have an idea for a video, please leave it in the comments below.